I'm going now to share the worksheet, the lecture, sorry. Okay. Okay, let us start. So it's about statistics, right? What you have to know is what's the meaning of population. What's the meaning of population? What's the meaning of population? Guys, what's the meaning of population? What's the population of to be studied? What's the population? Are you listening to me?
Yes, miss, it's the whole group that is being studied.
Exactly. It's the set of people, set of things that we are going to study. Okay? This set, it could be qualitative or quantitative. It could be quality or quantity. Okay?
Yes.
Let us see. I'm going now to start by this one. So the population is the set of all possible measurements or observations that might be our interest to study. And every element in this population, it's called the individual. Do you agree?
Yes.
Okay. For example, the inhabitants of a country constitute a population. Each inhabitant is an individual. Is it clear? So the set to be studied is the inhabitants in a country, right?
Yes,
and every person is the individual. It's an individual, it's every inhabitant, right?
Yes.
Okay, let us continue. Character or a variable. What I'm studying is the character. What I'm studying about employees, what I'm studying about students, about people, about a country, it's the character. So suppose, for example, as in the worksheet, we had the salary of employees. So the population are the employees and the character is the salary. If I'm talking about money or the numbers, this character is quantitative. But suppose, for example, I'm discussing how many students are tall or short. This is qualitative. I can't count tall. I can't count short. It's a quality, right?
Yes.
Okay. So quality, like, for example, the color of the eyes, short or tall, and the quantity, for example, how many children do I have in a certain family, how many students I have in a certain school. Okay, let us continue. What's the frequency? So suppose I'm asking you how many boys do I have now in this lecture. You tell me, for example, 5 boys. This is the frequency. So when I ask you about the frequency, how many of this thing?
Occurred again and again.
Okay, is it clear, this one?
Yes.
So yeah, the frequency is how many do I have from this character or from this variable? So if, look at this example. Can you see the table? Can you see the table? Of course, right? The assessment of 2,478 cars according to their mile age is given by. So if I ask you, for example, how many cars they have, do they have 12,000 kilometers as mile age? Do I repeat the question? Look at the table and answer.
821.
Very good, Ahmad. It's 821 cars. So 821 itself, it's called the frequency of a certain character. Sharif, is it clear till now? Ahmed Aw, did you have any question? Anyone have any question? Please ask me right
Miss
now.
Miss, فيك تعيد السؤال اللي سألتيه.
Okay, Kamal.
Miss, please repeat.
I'm asking you. If I asked you how many cars do they have 20,000 kilometers as a mile age? How many cars do they have in their mile age to 20,000 kilometers? It's 233. So I'm asking you to pick out from the table, Sharif. Look at the table. 4,000 kilometer, 8,000 kilometer, 12,000 kilometer, 16,000 kilometer.
Oh, okay.
Is it clear?
Yeah.
I think this is the same. You use it in biology, you use it in chemistry. So you are familiar with the table, right? And the unit. Pay attention to the unit. So I'm asking you, how many cars, what's the number of cars that they have 20,000 kilometers as mile age? You just read the frequency, which is 233.
Yes.
Okay. So till now, is it clear how do we pick out the frequency?
Yes, very clear.
And which is important is the total. So pay attention. When you add all the frequencies, you should get the total number of cars. Let us continue. This is the total frequency I was telling you about. So when you add all the frequencies, you will get the total. What's the meaning of relative frequency? You used to learn this last year. You know how to bring the percentage, right?
Yes.
So I'm going to go back to the table. If I ask you, I want the percentage of cars that have 16 as mile age. What do you do?
475.
Divide.
Frequency over total.
Exactly. 100. Yes, Sammy. Sammy, I think I heard you. Yes, Sharif, all of you, very good. So I take the frequency over the total times 100.
Times 100.
Very good. This is the relative frequency in percentage. But I might ask you about the relative frequency itself without percentage.
Yeah, frequency over total.
Very good, Sammy.
We only divide.
Very good, excellent. So you just divide the frequency over the total itself. This is the relative frequency. If you multiply it by 100, you're going to get the relative frequency in percentage.
Yes.
Clear? Please. Anyone have any question about this one?
No.
Yes, no.
Yes, ask.
Yes, I didn't get it.
Sharif, okay. Look at this. Maybe if the table was given in another way, you might find it easier. Look at this, Sharif, look at the table. Okay. You have 4,228, 8,634, 12,000, they are 821 cars. If I ask you, for example, I need the percentage of cars that have 4,000 kilometers. You look at the table. How many cars? They have 4,000 kilometers.
228.
It's in percentage, not in number of cars. So what do? You put this number over the total and you multiply it by 100.
Miss, which number?
228, the frequency. The frequency. You put the frequency
over 4 times
100. Over the total number of frequencies times 100.
Yeah, 228 over 2,478.
Very good, times 100. And then you will get the percentage of cars and then the number of cars.
Oh, okay.
Damon, over the total?
Every time you need to find the percentage, you have to put it over the total.
Okay.
Let us continue. So this is the relative frequency. And as you can see, this is the relative frequency and the relative frequency and percentage. The sum of the relative frequency is 1, so that the relative frequency and percentage, their total is 100. Any question about this one?
No.
Okay. No. So the relative frequency should be, their total is 1, and the relative frequency and percentage should be 100. Let us continue. Now the increasing cumulative frequency. The increasing cumulative frequency. Look at the table. I'm going just to make it slideshow. Okay. So look at the increasing cumulative frequency. In order to find it, what do? You place the first number, which is 28. Did you see?
Yes.
So you place the first number, which is 228. You add it with the second frequency.
834.
So it's 860.
802.
And then we add it with?
821.
Very good. We add it with 821. So the answer is 1683. Now what do I do?
We add it with.
Very good. We add it with 475. We get 2158. And then we add it with?
233.
So the answer is 2391. And then? We add it with?
Plus 87.
The last number should be the same as the total.
Yes.
The last number should be the same as the total. Is it clear?
يعني هاي خاصة بأول table?
Yes. The same exercise I'm doing all over the lecture. It's about the cars and the mile age.
Okay.
Okay, the increasing cumulative relative frequency. Every time you hear the word relative frequency, what do? You put this value over the total.
And times 100.
If I ask you in percentage. If not, you keep it as it is.
Yes.
Great. Is this clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Great. So till now we learned what's the meaning of population. The character, what I'm studying about this population, what's the meaning of a frequency. We learned how do I find the relative frequency, which is the frequency over the total. If I want it in percentage, you multiply it by 100. And now we learned the increasing cumulative frequency. Is this clear?
Yes.
Yeah, now I'm going to continue. Now the sample of, or the survey, it's about the set. The set, it's sometimes the sample is a very big number. Or it could be a small number. If it's big number, we aren't now a statistic. It's a survey. Is it clear? Did you distinguish the difference between them?
Yes.
Yeah, let us continue. This is an exercise and we are going to solve everything we learned till now. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, we have here a table. The number of books owned by 20 students of the first secondary. So we have students in the first secondary. They owned books. How many students do we have?
Miss Ahmed Audi Alik, can you repeat the survey?
Ah, okay, okay. ما بعرف لي ما بينت عندي بالشات. Let me check. Okay, I'm going to repeat it. When I'm, for example, talking about people in a certain country, we are doing a statistic, but when I'm talking about people in different countries all over the world, for example, it's a survey.
Yani big is survey.
Yes. Okay, here we have, so the number of books owned by 20 students. So what's, first of all, what's the total number of students in this class?
52.
Total number of students?
20.
20 students. By 20 students of the first secondary. Okay. What's the population?
Students.
Very good. The population is 20 students. What's the character or the variable?
The books.
Very good. The books owned by those students. Is it quantitative or qualitative?
Quantitative.
Very good, Sami. It's quantitative. So the population is the 20 students. One individual is the student. And the variable is the number of books of each student, owned by each student, and it's quantitative. Any question till now?
No.
Okay.
No.
In number two, we changed those values into a table.
Yes.
You put above the variable. What do you put in a table above? You know that the table, we have two parts. In biology and in chemistry or in physics, you put the x-axis above and the y-axis below, right?
Yes.
In math, we put the variable in x and the frequency in y. So above the variable and the frequency below. Is it clear?
Okay.
Yes. The variable, we said that the variable is the number of books owned. And the frequency is the number of students. So how many students they have 45 books? You just count them. Count them from the above table. How many students they have 45 books?
Three.
Okay. How many students they have 48?
Six.
Okay. So just a minute. I'm just going to annotate. Okay. So here, for example, how many books, how many students they have 52? This is one, two, three, four, 52. Okay. So that's how we count them. How can I know that my answer is correct?
Frequency.
We add
45 with 3 with 48.
Pay attention.
3 plus 6 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1 plus 4. If it's equal to the total, then it's correct.
Very good. So I add the frequencies, which is 3, 6, 4, 2, 1, 4. They should be equal to the number of students given, which is 20. Very good, Ahmed. Any question till now, please? If you have any question, ask me right now.
No, thank you.
Okay.
Miss, I'm coming Z the frequency. I'm coming Z all the frequencies together.
Usually we add only the frequencies together. We can't add the characters. We can't add the variables.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So suppose, for example, I'm discussing about the color eyes. How many students they have green color? Can I add green with black, with blue? I cannot. So usually the variable, even if it's number, I can't add it. I just add the number of frequency to get me the total number of students.
Okay.
Great. Let us continue. So this is the number of books. How do I find the relative frequency, Sharif? We put the number of frequency on the total. So it's 0.15 and so on for the rest. How can I know that my answer is correct? We need to add all the relative frequency they should get.
One.
Very good. So the addition of all the relative frequency, it should be one. Very good. Any question till now?
No.
If I want them in percentage, just what I do is?
Multiply by 100.
Very good. Excellent. Okay. Increasing cumulative frequency, it's very easy. I'm going to annotate it here. Okay, so we just placed the first number, which is 3. Now 3 plus 6 is?
9.
9 plus 4 is?
13.
13 plus 2?
15.
15 plus 1 is?
16.
Plus 4 is?
20.
Very good, Sammy. So the last number, which is 20, it should be equal to the
total frequency.
Total
number of frequency, which is 20 students. Now, every time you hear the word relative frequency, what you do is to put that this value over the total.
Yes.
Okay. Let us continue. Now, graphical representation, the line diagram. I think you know what's the line diagram. I told you just before, the abscissa-axis, which is the x-axis, it's the variable, and the ordinate axis, it's the frequency.
Yes.
So, this is Suppose you have this table, you have the shoe size and the frequency. So how many, for example, children, how many child they have size 25?
Five
children. How many child they five. Have 20? Very good. Okay, so the total number of children they should be? 20 children, okay?
20.
Very good. And the relative frequency. Just to give you a hint, in this table, we can draw two line diagrams. What are they?
Yeah. Either frequency and the shoe size or relative frequency and the shoe size.
Very good. I can ask you the shoe size with the frequency or the shoe size with the relative frequency. I think you know this from the biology or from the physics, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
So suppose yeah. The question is, suppose I asked you to draw the line graph of the frequency with the shoe size. Can you see this line diagram or line graph?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah. And suppose I asked you, I want the shoe size with the relative frequency. So this is the second line graph. In both cases, the shoe size will always be in the axis of abscissa. Okay.
Yes.
Any question?
No.
No.
Let us continue. No. Now the circular diagram or the pie chart. You know what's the circle? How can I find the angle, the degree? This is the rule. The degree
over
360, it's equal to the frequency over the total frequency. Okay? So I'm going to give you an example. If you still have any question, you can ask me. So we have the first secondary, second secondary, and third secondary, and the technical. We have 610 students in the first secondary, 545 in the second secondary, and 590 in the third secondary, and 110 students in the technical. And the total number of students is 1,855. So the angle, how can I know the angle for the first secondary? It's the angle that I need to find over 360. It's equal to 610 over 1,855. And you do the cross multiplication, then the angle is 118. Any question about this one? It's only a rule and you are applying.
Yes.
Okay. So after finding each one, how can I check that my answer is correct?
Their total was
if the total is equal to 1,
if the total was 1855,
if the total of the angles is equal to
360,
very good. So if the total number of or the total degrees is 360, then your answer is correct, and then you can construct this pie chart. Can you see it?
Yes.
So if you add 118, 106, 115, and 21, it's going to be 360. Do I continue, guys?
Yes.
Okay. Let us continue. Now we are going to take about some specific. Till now, we learned how do we find the percentage and the increasing cumulative frequency. But in some cases, you might have many tables. They have the same increasing cumulative frequency. They have the same percentage. They have the same relative frequency, for example. But there are some positions that we can calculate them in order to distinguish between two statistics. Okay. One of them is the mode. What's the meaning of the mode? The mode, it's the number which is most frequent. What's the meaning of most frequent? It has the most frequency.
The biggest number.
The biggest frequency. So if you look at this table or this series, we have 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 5, 6. The mode is 3 because it appears 4 times, which is the most occurring. So if you have a series like this, you can know the mode directly. But what if you have a table?
Yes.
What if we have a table? How can I know the mode?
The one with the highest number.
The one with the highest frequency. Yes, Ahmad. So if we have a table, so we look at the most frequency. Sometimes the mode
Miss
is
Masset.
Not. Yes.
Total مخصص, huh?
No. In the mode, the total, okay. We ignore it, okay? Sometimes the mode is more than one number. If you look at this series, what's the mode? Two. It's repeated three
times. Two and four.
Very good. Two and four. Yes, Sammy. Because two is repeated three times and four is repeated three times. So the mode in this case is two and four. So we have two modes. And this we call it bimodal. Why do we call it bimodal? Because it has
two.
If it has more than two, then we call it multimodal. Any question?
Yeah. No.
Okay.
No.
Let us continue now. Now, what's the median? To calculate the median, I have two conditions or two cases. Two cases. Let us look at the first case and then we are going to see the second case. The case of a series of values not grouped in a table. If I have this series, how can I find the median? If the total is odd, then the median is the total plus one over two. Okay, let us take an example. This is a series. We have 3, 5, 8, 9, 11, 14, 7. Just count how many numbers do I have in this series?
Seven.
So I have seven values. Seven is an odd number. So what do we do? 7 plus 1 over 4, which is 8.
Over two.
Four,
which is four. Is it clear? Is it hard?
Yes.
Just write it as a note.
No.
If the frequency is odd, then n plus 1 over 2. Now, what if the total is even?
We must do two things.
What are they?
N over 2. N over 2 plus.
That's very good.
Average over.
Very good, Fatima. So, look at this series. We have 5, 7, 8, 8, 10, 11, 13, 14, 14, 16. So how many values do we have?
10.
12, right?
12, sorry.
Okay. No, they are 10. You were right, Ahmad. They are 10 values. So what do we do? 10 over 2 is?
5.
10 over 2 plus 1 is?
5.5.
It's 6. So the median in this case is 5.5, which is? You take the 5 and the 6. Look, you don't 11. Add 5 plus 6 and you do their average. What's the fifth position? Look at the position. You count the position. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the fifth position and this is the sixth position. So you add those two values, 10 plus 11 over 2. Do I repeat?
I understood.
Okay, so we find n over 2 and n over 2 plus 1. We take their positions, the values in this position, and we find their average. Is it clear, Fatima? Okay. Let me now continue. Of course, we were finding the median in the case where we had a series. Now, what if I have a table?
Miss them, kick us out of the Zoom call.
We still have 1 minute, okay? Do you have any other Zoom after my Zoom?
No.
We still have like
1 minute.
1 minute.
But I'm asking you, do you have another live after the mathematics? Do you have anything after my Zoom?
Miss, to me, your voice is really loud.
Okay, I'm asking
I don't know if they have Arabic or something.
Guys, please, if you don't have anything, just when the meeting is ended, please rejoin. I just need like 10 to 15 minutes. Can you?
Yes, miss.
Okay, so now let us continue. Now, what if we have a table? I'm going to go directly to the example. This is a table and I need the median, okay? So the total number of frequency is 13. So what's 13 over 2?
6.5
lies between 5 and 9. Can you see it?
Yes.
So we take the highest, yes, which is 9. We take the its grade, which is 15. Okay, so what we did is we have to find the increasing cumulative frequency, and then we do n over 2, which is 6.5, and 6.5 lies here in the middle. Okay, so we take the highest, which is 9. We take its grade, which is 15. Is it clear? It's not enough to, yes, look at it and, yes, listen to me.